In this video, we will learn how to install the current MySQL version on Windows 11. With that, we will also create a sample database. Let us start. At first, go to the web browser. On Google, type MySQL and press enter. The official website is visible, mysql.com. Click on it. Now click the downloads menu. Go below. And here MySQL community downloads are visible. Click on it. After clicking, go to MySQL installer for Windows here. Now the current version is visible. That is the following. Here two versions are visible. Okay. We will download the following. Here x86 32 bit is visible, but this works for 64 bit Windows operating system also. So we will download the following 354 MB version. Click the download button. Now click no thanks, just start my download. The download started. Let's wait. It's only 354 MB. We have downloaded the installer file. Right click and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. The installation started. Choose a setup type. Here I'll go for custom. After selecting, click next. Now let us select the products. Okay, I'll click on MySQL servers. Click here. And the following is MySQL server. Click the arrow button. Now we have added it here, products to be installed. Do the same for others. That is, click applications, MySQL Workbench 8.0. Select the workbench, drag it. Okay. Now go for shell. Click here. And that's it. Now we will install server, workbench and shell. Click next. Ready to install all of them. Click execute. Now it will install one by one. Let's wait. The installation is complete. Click next. Click next. Here type and networking is visible. Keep it as it is. The port number is 3306. Do not change anything. Click next. Select the authentication method. We will go for the recommended one, that is use strong password encryption. Click next. Now we need to create our own password. Root password is the admin password. I have created it. You can create your own password, but you need to remember this password so that you can start the server later on. Click next. Windows service. Click next. Server file permissions. This is the location where your databases will get saved. Keep the default, that is yes, grant full access. Click next. Apply configuration. Click execute. The configuration is successful. Click finish. Click next. After the installation is complete, Workbench will start as well as MySQL shell. Click finish. Okay, before moving further, let us see the location and set the path. We installed MySQL in C drive, program files. Go below, click MySQL, server, bin, and copy this path. Minimize, go to start, type environment variables, click open, click environment variables, double click path, click new and paste the same path. Here it is. Now click OK, OK, and the last OK. We have installed MySQL. Let us verify and start the server for the first time. Go to start, type cmd, click open, type MySQL space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. This shows that we successfully installed the current MySQL version. So now whenever you want to start MySQL, go to start, type cmd, click open, and type the command MySQL space hyphen u root space hyphen p and press enter. Here u is for user, which was root, I hope you remember, and p is for password. Press enter, enter the same password, press enter again, and we have successfully started the MySQL server. Now let us create a new database. First I'll check the default databases. Type show databases command. Now I'll type create database, database name. So I am just typing a new database name, which is AmitDB. You can add any name. Press enter. Query OK. One row affected is visible. That means we successfully created a new database. Use the same command to verify. Type show space databases semicolon and press enter. Here it is. Now AmitDB database is visible. For a free MySQL tutorial, refer to the link in the description of the video. Now you would be wondering, what is the use of MySQL Workbench? Consider it as a UI to create databases and tables in MySQL Workbench. With that, we can also perform other operations. The same is written here. You can read. Click here. Type the same password. Save password. Click OK. We have opened MySQL Workbench, so you can create your databases, tables, and perform operations using MySQL Workbench also. For a free MySQL Workbench tutorial, refer to the link in the description of the video.